All right, folks, got the little rascal up on the table. Got it semi-mocked up, kind of in a roller form. That way I can figure out where my wheel alignment and all that's going to be, because I'm going to show you my attempt to do something different to this little rascal. So, let's take a peek at it. You know, some old school bikes had a suspension seat on it, right? Well, Go Power Sports carries these cool shocks. They fit real good on some of the old vintage bikes that I put them on. They bolt right into place, and they're also adjustable. And they have a ton of these brackets. And if y'all guys don't have these brackets laying around in your toolbox or on your shelf, if you're working on bikes, go-karts, these things come in extremely handy. You ain't got to sit there and make something and find a piece of metal and cut it, drill holes in it. They have three different sizes. You got the small one right here. You got like a medium size. And you got one that's a little bit bigger. You can kind of line them up here so you can kind of get the gist of it. One's a little bit shorter. So you got three different sizes. So I had a bunch of these laying around, and I had the rascal, and I was like, man, what kind of cool trick am I going to do with this thing? How can I make it different than every other rascal? Hey, so I'm just thinking I could take some of their gussets. Got two at the bottom. I have another one up here at the top. I made a seat pan, which is kind of rough looking right now, but I'm gonna just clean it up. It's in rough form. So I'm trying to mock up my angle where I could put my pivot point, which I took two of their smaller ones and kind of cut some excess off of them. And I think this is gonna be my hinge part right here that's gonna go in the front. I'm gonna try and tuck it up underneath here so you don't really see a lot of it. And I'm gonna be able to use their factory seat that they sent me with it. So I'm still trying to mock up and figure out, you know, got issues on how high or how low I can put the shock mount mounted down here at the bottom. And I gotta make sure I have enough clearance on this side over here so I'm not, get this cable out of the way, so I'm not interfering with the chain and whatnot right here. So that's my plan, is to put the little rear suspension on the back. So, anyway, like I said, we're just in the mock-up stage right now. When I get further along and figure out exactly where I'm going to get stuff done, I'll probably throw a few tacks on the brackets and on the seat pan and get everything lined up, because I want to make sure and mock everything up before I fully weld it and get it on the ground, see how it actually sits. I know it is going to raise the seat up a little bit more, but hey, this might be really cool if you want to do this to your rascal and you're kind of a tall fella and you want the seat a little bit higher. You can get the seat a little bit higher and have a more cushiony ride on the back. So that's what we're going to attempt to do this bike. So let's see how it goes. All right, folks. Today we're going to work on the engine for the little rascal. Not little rascal, the rascal. Excuse me. So this is the 212R. That they supplied me with. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull the tank off, because I'm not gonna use the tank, the fuel tank that came on the engine. I'm gonna use their spun aluminum tank that come in the kit. And also, since I'm going to repaint some parts on the motor, I'm gonna go ahead and get those taken off today and get those ready to get stripped and painted. Got the paint on the way. I'm waiting on some special bushings that I ordered from Amazon or eBay for the mock-up on the frame. And then I finally got the email the other day that the guy no longer had any in stock. So that kind of put me behind. So in the meantime, we'll get the motor stripped down and get everything off of it that I want to powder coat or repaint. I'm probably going to strip the fan shroud and the starter assembly, get that all taken apart. And a lot of people ask, hey, what do you strip it with? Well, this is the stuff that I use. If this zooms in, I get this at Walmart. It's a paint varnish stripper. So I use this and I hose it down real good. And I kind of cheat a little bit. I don't sit there and scrub it off with a brush. I'll sit there and drag out the old handy pressure washer and I just pressure wash it. Blows it all right off. Then you get it all cleaned up. Then you can choose your point, your paint, primer, whatever you're going to use in that case. But we'll get this thing ripped apart and go from there. So we'll just sit you down right here and y'all can take a watch. Really hate to strip the paint off this pretty blue color, but the blue is not gonna go with the paint scheme, but it'll be okay.
get this carburetor job over here out of the way so I knock it off. Keep this bag so we can cover it back up so it doesn't get full of dirt.
So let's go ahead and get the tank. Let me get a 10 millimeter. Go ahead and get the tank yanked off of it. Where's my magnetic tray? Keep one of them handy so you put all your bolts in it. Like I said, I got the paint on the way, and this bike we're gonna go back with some Ed Roth. So whenever I get that stuff in, you'll be surprised what color I paint that. It's not gonna go too flashy, but I think it'll look cool for this build to match the seat anyway. I'm kind of building the paint scheme around the Go Power Sports sparkly black and silver seat. So, and we're gonna pull this throttle linkage off because we have a throttle plate, which I'll show you that in a second, that we're gonna put on it. And I got a top engine mount plate that's gonna hold the fuel tank, so. This out of the way. Get that done, we'll take the fuel line off. Get to the clamp here. Slide that right up there. Go ahead and get the clamp off. Put that in there. Should pull the tank right off. Oh, probably ought to take the spring off this right here too. If I could see it. All right, now I should be able to pull the tank off. There we go. Snake the fuel line out. We'll put this in a box, save that for another project for sure. Now we'll go ahead and take this ground wire off for the kill switch. Because we're not gonna use this kill switch, the kit for the Rascal. Actually comes with a handlebar mounted kill switch. Is in my opinion a lot safer than trying to use this one. So if something happens, you can easily reach your handlebar switch than trying to reach down on the motor and use this kill switch. So we're just gonna do this plug here. I'm gonna pop the kill switch out. There we go. We'll set that to the side. We'll keep that for something else. All right. Go ahead and get the starter off. Probably could use the impact driver, but oh well. I gotta try and ease this sticker off so I can take the sticker and put it on my toolbox because I like stickers. Anyway, so I get all the guts out of this, get this ready to get stripped, get the fan shroud off. We'll get it stripped today, get it cleaned up, get some primer on this. When the paint comes in, it'll be ready. And I think I'll go ahead and pull the valve cover off also. I was kind of debating whether to leave the valve cover or paint the valve cover. Or powder coat it. I do a little home baked powder coat myself, so of the parts that I can fit. So I'll have to show you all that whenever I get to that step. So I think we'll go ahead and paint it or chrome powder coat. Not sure. We'll do something with the valve cover. And one more. Can't hold on to nothing. Get over there. like I said, we'll put a top engine plate on this. So they sent that to me the other day, so I'm gonna find that and the top frame plate. So we'll get this. Man, that's a pretty color blue. Wow. Oh, there's another sticker I gotta try and ease off. Anyway, so I get this all stripped, get the fan shroud and the starter housing stripped and ready for paint. All right, I'm not gonna use this. So let's get this out of the way. Spring off, don't need that. And we put this one back over here. I'll just hang this right here right now. So it's out of the way. All right, let's go ahead and yank the valve cover off. Well, I think we might powder coat this. This tube out. So you need to put a filter on that. Then we take a peek at the valves in this thing. This will be the actual first Tilson motor. I built a Tilson, one of the 228 stroker build-it-yourself kits that Go Power Sports has. And I've done a couple heat cycles with it on the floor, but I'm waiting for another project that's in line to build another race bike that I'll be putting that engine on. So I actually haven't put one of these on a bike and actually rode it, but they definitely sound way beefier. And the way they built the block, ooh, what is that? The way the block is definitely made, it's a whole different animal. So you can get the gasket out. Maybe you might better leave the gasket. There we go. And ease this gasket out so we can reuse it without breaking it. There we go. You put that somewhere right there. That way I can get this prepped and ready for paint also. Nice. Let's go ahead and we'll go ahead and flip it on its back. Let's take this off. What that is. Oh, I guess it's a little rubber, keep it from rattling maybe? Or they might have run some kind of vent tube through it. Let's see what that is. I guess it's just a little, anybody know what those are on there for? Never seen those on there. I guess they maybe keep this from rattling or something. That's kind of odd, never seen it. Anyway, maybe I'll leave them in there. I'll pop them out. We'll either paint it or powder coat it, whatever we're gonna do, and maybe I'll pop them back in there, I guess. I have no idea what those are for. But anyway, I'll get this, bag back up so no dirt, debris, or nothing gets in it. And we'll get everything else painted and we'll go from there. Let me show you the plate that I'll be using. Go Power Sports here. I got a cool letter from Mike. Mike is one of the guys in the back. I'm gonna show you all this at a separate date. I've known Mike that works for Go Power Sports for a very, very long time. And actually met him in person numerous times. Really cool guy. And anyway, he's just one of the cool cats that writes me notes sometimes on my invoices that I get for when they ship me stuff. And it's very cool. Very cool from Mike. Great cat. Anyway, this is the top engine plate. I think they call this one the full plate. So this is what we're gonna put on the top. And actually, I'm gonna redo all the throttle linkage or maybe get rid of the governor. I haven't thought about that yet. But this is the plate that basically mocks up here. It's got all your throttle linkage. And it's very, very cool. Everything, if you install it correctly like you're supposed to, the pull on it, everything, the throttle return is extremely nice. I put the same one on a couple other bikes, but it's like the ARC type that Go Power Sports carries. But anyway, so we're gonna put this plate on the top. Got some snazzy stickers again. And this is gonna be the top plate that they sent me that goes on the top of the frame and goes right on top. And the fuel neck for the spun tank mounts underneath the frame, and the tank neck will actually come through here. So this is either gonna get painted or powder coated, one of the two. So that's where we're at on that. So that's gonna be it for today. And I'm gonna get all this stuff primed or stripped and ready for primer and go from there. All right, after looking at this bike more and more, I was thinking, man, I would really like to put fenders on the bike. I put fenders on the Little Rascal, and I really like how it turned out. So I was digging around in my stash pile and come across two brand new, I do believe these are Coleman TC T100U, I think. It's this very small Coleman. That's what these fenders are that come on there. Of course, they have these real big holes. I mean, that's big. So I got holes to fill on them because that is not going to be cool. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to do to fill these holes. I could put just a washer in it, but all the washers I have are either too big or way too small to grind down. So I do have a hole saw bit that is almost the exact same diameter. So let's show you what we got here. This is how I'm going to do it. Take a handy old hole saw. I think this was like an inch and a quarter bit. So we're going to come over here and punch out a hole. Already got one punched out. Alright, we're going to let that one cool off, but I have another one right here that I've already done. So at least I have a lot smaller hole to fill up whenever I go to weld it. But I can lay this right up inside there after I smooth it down a little bit and get that welded in. Then I'll go ahead and weld in the two smaller holes and put some all metal stuff, kind of like Bondo, in there to fill that up. But that's a nifty little trick that I had because every washer I said either was way too big or way too small. But yeah, so then I'm also gonna have to get up here and I'm gonna take the bracket that they have on here from the factory where you can mount a fender on it, and I'm gonna cut it and drop it because I want my fender sitting real low on the tire. Do the same thing on the front forks. I'm gonna take a piece that I cut out of the frame. This was a piece that I cut out of the top of the frame that mounts your seat. Since I'm going to be doing something different with the seat, I didn't want this up there. So I'm going to take this piece that I cut out and use it to mount my front fender on the front forks. So I'm going to get these stripped down. I still got to strip all the red paint off of them, get those sandblasted and stripped. But I'm going to start welding these up, get all the holes filled. Good times! All right, folks, I'm going to call it a day. I did decide to go ahead and strip everything off the motor since I had the fan shroud and all that stuff getting it ready for paint. So I did go ahead and get the block clean and prep, wiped it down with lacquer thinner and got it all taped off and put the good old fashioned cast iron on it. So I think it looks pretty good. Anyway, so did decide to go with fenders. And like I said, I cut out the little plug things. They're just kind of roughed in. I still got to get the rest of the paint off the fenders and get them all smoothed down. I gotta weld up a little bit more, get these stripped, put a little filler in them. And I did take and get this tacked into place because this is where my rear fender is gonna mount. This bracket, let's see here, this bracket was actually up here. So I actually cut it out, moved it down, rolled it at a different angle, and I'm gonna use their bracket and because I want my fender tucked down where it's real close to the tire. So that's where I got for that today. And let's see, I got the other bracket laying here somewhere. This is gonna go for my front fender. Gotta get this, punch some holes in that, get that tacked in, and then wait for the rest of my bushings to come in the mail for the seat project part of it. And hopefully to get those, I've been waiting and waiting for those, but getting those through Amazon or eBay or somewhere. So I'm waiting for those to get in, so I can get back on the rest of the suspension part on the seat. Once I get all that welded up, it'll be ready to get the frame prepped, get it primed, get the frame painted, and start powder coating parts. So, we'll see y'all later. Gonna call it a day.